Hello students, welcome to our page. I hope you already liked, subscribed and shared our page. And still, if you haven't done that, please like, subscribe and share our page and also press the bell icon so you will get the updates in the future. Now today we are going to start the new example, that means the next example from the exercise 8.2, which already we had started in this series of lectures. And I hope you watched all the videos up to question number 6 and still if you haven't watched, you can watch those videos from the links which are given in the description. Now, without wasting any time, we are going to start the example. Now, the example is like this. A milkman sold two of his buffaloes for ₹20,000 each. On one, he made a gain of 5% and on the other, he had a loss of 10%. Find his overall gain or loss. Now they are asking us like this only, find his overall gain or loss. They are not asking like gain or loss percentage like in the question number 5. Actually this example is similar to that example number 5. So you can also watch that video. From that also you can get idea about this example. That means here actually two buffaloes are there and we have to calculate their CP. That means milkman sold two of his buffaloes for 20,000 each. So here we don't know the CP. So that means we have to calculate CP for each buffalo with the help of gain percentage and with the help of loss percent, which are given in the example. And then we have to combine the SP of each buffalo, CP of each buffalo, and after that you can decide which one is larger. If SP is larger, then profit is there or gain is there. And if CP is larger, then obviously the loss is there. So you can easily find out from the CP and SP. So we will find out the CP for first buffalo. So here actually SP for each buffalo is same. So there is no need to change that value, which is ₹20,000. Okay. Now we will consider the first buffalo. For that first buffalo, the milkman made a gain of, how much gain he is obtained? Made a gain of 5% while selling the one buffalo. So, first buffalo giving him a 5% of profit. Gain means profit. Okay. So, here we are going to use the formula for profit. So, that's why profit is there. So, therefore, if we consider the CP is 100, then SP is going to be 105. SP is going to be 105. So CP of one buffalo, we are going to calculate it like this. CP of one buffalo, which is equals to CP upon SP, that means 100 upon 105 into 20,000. Now you are going to say that we had watched the previous video of question number 5 and in that case you had given the formula like SP upon CP. Now, why we are changing the formula? Because in that case, we are calculating the SP and here we are calculating the CP. So, that's why the formula is going to be different. So, here CP upon SP, that will be the formula. That means 100 upon 105. Now, here we have to just simplify it. Here we have to just simplify it. Suppose I will divide it by 5. Then 5 2s are 10, 5 1s are 5, so 21. And here 25 is 100, so 20 is there. So in this way we can perform the calculation and we are going to divide it further, and after dividing it we are going to get the value 19,047.62 is the CP of the first buffalo. That means that milkman buying that buffalo, he is buying that buffalo, that means he is taking that buffalo at the cost of 19,047.62. So this is the CP for first buffalo. Now we will find out CP for the second buffalo. Now for second buffalo, when that milkman had sold that buffalo, he had a loss of 10% on that second buffalo. So loss means you have to subtract the value. So if CP is 100, then SP is going to be 90. Then SP is going to be 90. So therefore CP of the other buffalo, that means second buffalo, is going to be 100 upon 90 into 20,000. That means CP upon SP into 20,000. Now zeros are going to be cancelled. Here one zero is going to be cancelled. Then here you can perform the multiplication. 100 into 2000. Just keep two zeros in front of that. So 2 lakh divided by 9. And after doing that, we are getting it 22,222.22 is the CP of second buffalo. So now I had obtained both the CPs. The work is remained to combine those CPs and combine those SP, and after that we are able to understand whether he is having loss or gain. So total CP is going to be calculated by adding these two values. Which two values? First value is 19,047.62 and second value is 22,222.22, and after adding that I am getting the answer 41,269.84, which is the total CP for both buffalo, and total SP is going to be 20,000 plus 20,000 because each buffalo having the selling price of 20,000. You can also do it by adding, or you can also do 20,000 into 2, which is equals to 40,000. Now you are able to identify which value is greater, 41,269 or 40,000. So anyone can tell that CP is greater than SP by observing those two values. So here I can say that SP is less than CP. So therefore there was a loss because SP is less and CP is more. So that's why there is a loss. And how much loss is there? You can calculate it with the help of formula CP minus SP, larger minus smaller value. So larger is CP, so CP minus SP, and after performing that subtraction we are getting the answer 1269.84, which is the loss for that milkman. So therefore overall loss of milkman was Rs 1269.84. So in this way we are able to calculate the overall gain or overall loss. So this is the second example of similar type, and same example we had considered the question number 5, which you can access the video from the link which is given in the description. I hope you understand the example. Next time you are able to solve it without referring any notes or without referring any video. So if you like the video, then please like, subscribe and share our page, and also press the bell icon. Also press the bell icon so you will get the updates in the future. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.